Veterans Day Assembly, take six.
It's 3:47. Where is Sanaa?
I don't know. Where is she?
Hey, guys. Sorry I'm late.
Hey, Sanaa. That's okay. But what happened? Why are you so late?
Well, my mom's friend was over, and he's a veteran. I was talking to him about Veterans Day.
Oh, what did he have to say?
Well, her friend's name is Javier, and he was telling me about his time in the Army.
Really? Is he in the Army now?
No. Javier joined when he was 17 years old and stayed in for 4 years.
17? That's so young. Why did he join the Army?
Well, he was having a little bit of trouble in school, and one of his teachers suggested that he joins the service to get his life back in order. And also, he could use the GI Bill to go to college.
Did the Army help him with that?
Yeah. When you go to the Army, you have to go through basic training. There, you do a lot of physical exercises, equipment training, and you also learn how to work as a team with your fellow soldiers. Javier said he went in the Army as a boy, but left with the confidence of a man.
What's the GI Bill, and how would that help him with college?
I've heard of that before. My uncle's a Marine, and he used to go to school after he finished serving in his country. If you serve in one of the armed services for at least 3 years and get honorable discharge, then you can get money from the government to use towards your college education.
That's awesome. These guys who serve deserve something like that. Hey, Sanaa, did Javier qualify and use his GI Bill?
Yes, he did. Javier spent 4 years in the Army from 2001 to 2005 and achieved the rank of an E-4 specialist. During his time in the Army, he was stationed all the way in Iraq.
No way! So is my Uncle Marco. He was a part of the Operation Iraq Freedom, and his battle line helped him free Baghdad from Saddam Hussein's troops.
Wow, your uncle must have seen some real action, Jose. He's probably got some wild stories to tell.
I'm proud of my uncle for his service, but he doesn't like to talk about all of that action. He says the things that our veterans have endured to maintain our safety and to protect other countries are not exactly stories to share around the dinner table. He also says that every man in or woman in uniform is a hero, just their willingness to serve.
He's right about that. My mom told us that we should be grateful for our veterans, but we also have to be respectful of their privacy. Taking time to really talk to a veteran about their service time is fantastic. It shows that you really care, but as for the action stories, always remember that sharing the hardships of being deployed, especially in the Middle East, may not be the stories that a Marine or any other serviceman feels comfortable talking about.
You're right, Sanaa. My grandpa was in the Vietnam War, and I know that he doesn't like to talk about any of the bad stuff either. My mom has always reminded us not to ask any direct, personal things about the war, but instead to say, "Papa, would you like to share any stories about your time in the Army?" That way, he was able to choose what to tell and what to skip.
That's a good idea. Now I know how to approach a veteran if I want to ask about their time in service. Sanaa, did Javier have a good time in Iraq?
He did, but only some of the funny stuff. He said that one time when his unit was returning home from Iraq, they had a stopover in Kuwait. When they got into the base in Kuwait, they had been awake for over 24 hours and had about 2 hours to stop at the base and rest.
24 hours without sleep? That's terrible. I bet he couldn't wait to get to bed at the base. 2 hours is better than nothing.
Yeah, well, guess what? Javier and his friend never even bothered to rest because they found out the rest of their unit was stationed in that same base in Kuwait. So instead of sleeping, they found their unit, snuck into their barracks, and scared the crap out of them by tugging at their toes while they were all asleep. Javier said his good friend fell right off of his bunk and then jumped up ready to attack. But once he saw who it was, he started freaking out. All of his buddies got out of their bunks, and everyone was hugging each other and crying tears of happiness once they saw that their buddies were safe and sound. One of the things that Javier stressed during our conversation is that the bond between soldiers is about a bond that can never be broken. He said as a soldier, you really learn how to work together, to keep your responsibilities, and to watch the back of the other guys in your unit. He's probably got thousands of brothers across the United States that he knows from his time in the Army.
My uncle said the same thing. He said the Marines taught him to become accepting of everyone since you get guys from all over America joining the service. You really learn how to share the workload and to make sure you never let your fellow Marines down. He also said that in order to serve, you got to be physically tough, mentally tough, and you also need to have a sense of humor, he said. He said that as a soldier, you spend a lot of time with some groups of people and everyone loves to burst each other's chops.
My pop-up told me this funny story from his time in the Army. He said that during basic training, his sergeant asked if anyone had artistic abilities. Having been in the art club in high school, he raised his hand. Then the sergeant announced that everyone would get a 3-day pass to get off of the base and have fun. Everyone except him. While everyone else went out on leave, he had to stay behind and neatly print each soldier's name onto their Army-issued underwear. Pop-Up said it was the last time he raised his hand for anything. To make things worse, his friends bought him a souvenir from their leave.
Souvenirs are usually good. Why didn't he like his gift?
Because they brought him back a brand new pair of boxers. Pink boxers.
Hey, Carlos, does your pop-up still see enemy's war buddies from the Army?
Yes, he sees some of their yearly reunion and others at their veterans' home in Vineland.
Hey, I know where that is. We went there last year with student council. Everyone was so nice. It felt good to visit with them and help cheer them up by decorating their doors and their Christmas trees.
Javier told us something about that he works at the Veterans Multi-Service Center in Millville. His organization helps veterans in need too. Did you know that his organization helps a lot of homeless veterans?
Homeless veterans? You mean that there are soldiers who served our country and they don't have a place to live?
Yup. Sadly, that's true, but Javier works hard to get them the help that they need.
Man, I wish we could help.
So do I. Is there anything we can do?
Well, Javier said that his organization is always happy to get care packages that they can give out to the homeless veterans.
What kind of things could we get if we wanted to make some up?
He said homeless vets always need clean, warm socks, and they also need small travel size items like things of toothpaste, shampoo, and soap.
Why don't we ask Dr. Cook if student council could organize a donation drive? The Veterans Multi-Service Center is right in Millville. It would be easy enough to help out, and also a great way to thank some veterans who need a helping hand.
That's a great idea. Let's go ask him.
I'm stuck again.